Welcome back. Education for all, in other words, the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan of the government. Under this scheme, the government plans to universalize education for all the 19 crore children and give minimum 5 years of basic education. The government intends to tackle it on three fronts. First, provide primary education, improve and create infrastructure across 1.1 million destinations, and train teachers so that quality education can be standardized.
There are some good schools which are as good as schools in the rest of the world, and students from there are very well equipped to do higher learning, not only in India, but in any other part of the world. But this would be about 10% of the children coming out. The remaining 90% are much below their standards which they should have achieved. And this happens because while they are studying, there is no continuous system of monitoring their progress, ensuring that they have learnt what they are expected to learn. A framework for this would be usually called mastery learning, standards-based learning, and so on. And since that is lacking in most of the schools, and I will not distinguish between government and private, so a large number of students are not adequately equipped.
So also I want to understand, if you were asked, let's say, to suggest to the government three things that it should do.
Very simple. First, improve the lot of the teachers in the school. They are the worst paid lot, the most ignored lot. They are asked to do all kinds of things other than teaching. Number two, create for all those teachers a regular professional development program so that they are continuously upgraded and trained in the ways to teach and assess children and monitor that their progress has happened. Third is, forget about the infrastructure in terms of buildings and schools and so on, because learning can happen everywhere. So learning does not require classroom. Classroom is create a barrier which is created to learning. Learning can be anywhere where it is safe, nice, friendly, reasonably cool and acceptable. So I would say these are the three things. Make their lot much better so that good people want to be there. Empower them to become good teachers. If they want to do well, there has to be a professional training program for them. And of course, finally, they emphasize the learning teaching process, make learning fun. These are the kind of things I would say.
So, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, you have heard, must have heard
of
it.
Yeah.
Daily, maybe right. You must have also had a chance to get into it.
Yeah.
How far?
No. I don't even think it is worth discussing, because a government system which failed to give minimum literacy levels to people to date, that it can educate all children in that age group to the required level of schooling at the age of 14, it is simply not doable. Because India is such a diverse country, because statistically good and brilliant people are there, a certain part of it will be successful. So about 8 to 10% children will benefit. Because of poverty, if they were not going to school, they will be able to benefit. But 90% of the program will still be a disaster because there is no design put into it.
There are 1 crore children out there who have never experienced school. Out of that, 21 lakhs are from urban areas.
There are 15 lakh specially abled children, and half of them are out of school.
The first step in the development of a specially abled child is to stand. And it is here that the standing of the government in this special sector is badly affected. More than 50% of the 15 lakh specially abled children are still to experience what a school is like, which means a whopping 7.5 lakh children are out there waiting to see a school. And what do you require for all this? Infrastructure, special training, all that is very far and few to find.
For a special school, first of all, you need to have the kind of infrastructure required for mobility, because these kids cannot, go to the other floors or move out, because if they're not mobile, they cannot learn very much, right? It's not just the infrastructure, it is also the training of the staff. Besides the ambience and the environment required, which should be really joyful and optimistic. We need all the tools for teaching them. the technology for teaching them. And I feel so worried that when they're going to enter schools, hopefully regular ones, that those schools also have the wherewithal for welcoming them.
Where exactly is the problem? The problem areas in terms of resources, trained teachers,
it requires finance. See, even if you have the mindset, even if you want these children to go to regular schools, even if you create campaigns to tell the parents schools are available for you, but if they go into those schools, they should be first infrastructure, two manpower trained, three the tools. And the schools must have, resource centers where there is physiotherapy, special speech therapy, special education, vocational education. All this requires money. No, it doesn't exist. Actually, it's not enough to say education for all for primary school children. You need to have the budget for it. You have to have the funding for it. And within the regular funding, this will not be possible. You need an additional, amount to cover their needs.
The UPA government has major plans to reform the education system, change the face of education. The government plans to build new IITs, NITs, and reform the higher education system. The government has also spent and will be spending near to 9 billion rupees in the current financial year. But what the government really needs to relook at is the basic education system, which is in tatters. It's time for us to head into a short break. When we come back, we will take you to a private school for a status check.